enable.
The long-term success of any business is not entirely based on a healthy profit and loss statement. Worldwide, the companies that emerge as successful business leaders consider giving back to society equally important. Hello and welcome to a brand new series, The ChangeMakers on CNBC TV 18. I'm Ridhu Bhandari. In this series, we showcase the groundbreaking corporate social responsibility and sustainable development work of leading organizations, foundations, and the nonprofit sector that are working relentlessly towards creating a better world for various sections of the society. To achieve a better and more sustainable future for all, the United Nations has come up with the Sustainable Development Goals. We recognize those companies that have incorporated these Sustainable Development Goals in their business philosophy and are striving towards achieving a sustainable future for all. We call these responsible companies the changemakers. The UN has highlighted the universal and equitable access to safe and affordable drinking water for all by 2030 as part of its Sustainable Development Goals. The corporate sector has come in support of this cause by helping communities substantially increase their water use efficiency and ensure sustainable withdrawals and supply of fresh water. Today in this episode, we showcase United Breweries Ltd, a responsible corporate that is changing the face of rural India through its groundbreaking water conservation efforts. Take a look.
India is the first country in the world to make corporate social responsibility or CSR mandatory. Businesses today invest their profits in areas such as education, poverty, gender equality, water and hunger as part of their CSR compliance. One area that requires immediate attention from both corporate India as well as the community is solving India's water crisis. If left ignored, India's worst water crisis in its history is anticipated to worsen and adversely affect the country's GDP, accounting for almost 6% loss by 2050. One company that is trying to remedy this situation on ground is Bengaluru-headquartered United Breweries. The company has undertaken several projects in water conservation, replenishment and provision of safe drinking water to the communities in the vicinity of its breweries.
CSR in India for corporates like ours is of course mandated by the government of India. But I think most responsible corporates now look at CSR as a strategic initiative. Yes, the government does mandate us to do that. But a pure mandate like that cannot be translated into successful initiatives, because that can come only if the organization incorporates the CSR philosophy into its business strategy. And at United Breweries Limited, that's what we have done.
United Breweries prioritizes local area development in form of water conservation, safe drinking water and primary education. The company intends to balance its core commercial business goals along with initiatives that provide maximum social and economic benefit to society. And for this, it deploys the 4R strategy of reuse, reduce, recycle and recharge for efficient use of water. Recognizing the severity of India's water crisis, United Breweries has committed to being a water neutral company by 2025 and has already created a recharge potential of 83% of its production needs. In its endeavor to achieve this goal, the United Breweries has made water the most important pillar of its CSR programs.
Bulk of our CSR initiatives are centered on water. Because we do use water in our process and we want to be responsible in the way we utilize water, in the way we treat water. In Karnataka also, we have adopted a lake in the Chikbalapur area. We have also worked with water bodies which are connected to temples. We also worked on a rainwater harvesting project which benefits the villagers who live there. So it's an ambitious project which gives back to the community. Similarly, in Punjab, like I said, we have a brewery there, so therefore we have a connect with the communities who reside around the brewery. And there also we have adopted 6 water bodies which we are rejuvenating, because our belief is that water conservation has to happen across multiple levels. One, we have to reduce the amount of water we use, both as a corporate and as individuals. Two, we have to also learn to reuse the water, particularly in the corporate process and production process, we reuse a lot of water. And three, we have to recharge the water.
We do a variety of water conservation interventions, which include lake and pond rejuvenation, creation of earthen and cement nala bunds, watershed development, creation of gully plugs, gabions, and continuous contour trenches. So, no, to be specific, we have done rejuvenated 26 water bodies and created 52 water structures in the states of Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and Bihar.
45 kilometers away from central Bengaluru is the Nandi Gram Panchayat in Chikkabalapur district, where United Breweries conducts its various CSR initiatives, including water conservation, with the support of Panchayat members and its NGO partner, United Way Bengaluru. Nagappa, a marginal farmer from Sultanpet in Nandi Gram, is a beneficiary of the United Breweries CSR initiative. Owning a small piece of agricultural land, he was unable to manage his household expenses through agriculture due to drought and insufficient rain in the area. The United Breweries, in association with United Way Bengaluru, initiated a project to rejuvenate the Gundu Thopu in Sultanpet village that resulted in an increase in groundwater level, benefiting 1500 farmers like Nagappa living there. In the same premises, the old Kalyani Lake, with a capacity of 1300 kiloliters, has also been cleaned and restored with the help of United Breweries and United Way Bengaluru. A stepped well outside temples was used for bathing and cleaning before prayers. Children also use it for swimming and recreational purposes. This project, over the years, resulted in increased cultivation of 20 to 50% in 50 acres of land around Nandi Lake. The project will bring back cultivation in an additional 10 acres and reduce the cost of cultivation, which will directly affect the livelihood of approximately 500 small and marginal farmers. Malti from Nandi village also experienced hardship in accessing water for the household's day-to-day needs. The rainwater harvesting unit set up by United Breweries and United Way Bengaluru meant her daily life of hardship was soon to be a distant memory.
Memu neelaki chala dooram velle vallam chala kashtanga undedi asal maaki chala dooranga.
Earlier we used to travel miles to fetch water for our daily needs. It wasn't much to quench ours or the animals' thirst. The water problem got later solved by the UB group. They guided us on the rainwater storage and harvesting. Also built the system for us. There's no water problem now.
Another CSR project taken up by United Breweries was rooftop rainwater harvesting in the 4 villages of Nandi Panchayat that aims to cover 350 households over 3 years, coupled with the installation and construction of a 4,000-litre tank fitted with hand pumps. The tank can easily hold water required for 15 to 20 days. 50 households were covered in the last financial year and another 135 were done in the current year.
So, in the Chikkabalapur district of Karnataka, we have worked on water conservation issues in 5 villages of the Nandi Gram Panchayat. We have done rainwater harvesting for 350 households, which would make them water self-sufficient. They'll be able to take care of their water needs through their own rooftop rainwater. This project has helped 500 marginal and small farmers to have better livelihoods by getting better irrigation facilities through these water conservation efforts.
In collaboration with United Way Bengaluru, the United Breweries group has rejuvenated the Nandi Lake in the Nandi foothills. Accordingly, rainwater harvesting measures have been undertaken as well.
As a part of water neutral initiative, despite the fact that United Breweries does not have any plant in the vicinity of Dodbalapur, I really commend them because they chose to embrace this region and say, hey, we will take up this particular lake and undertake massive watershed initiatives. Rigorous measures were put in terms of how are we going to monitor and evaluate the progress of project at each milestone. And the beauty of the whole initiative is that every intervention is quantified. Like for example, today I can tell you after this intervention in a lake which we are currently working, which is about 38 acres, we will be conserving close to 4 lakh kiloliters of water. Or the rainwater harvesting initiative which we are working on will contribute and conserve close to 6,500 kilolakh liters of water.
One of the key elements of the Sustainable Development Goals of the United Nations is to achieve improved water and sanitation management through the support and strengthening of local communities. After the break, we take a look at how United Breweries is laying the roadmap to achieve this through its water conservation initiatives by engaging the local communities in Ludhiana. Stay with us on The Changemakers exclusively on CNBC TV 18. Welcome back to our brand new series, The Changemakers on CNBC TV 18. Engagement of the community is of paramount importance to the success of any social endeavor. In line with the United Nations Sustainable Development Goal to ensure availability and sustainable management of water, United Breweries has developed its CSR framework in Ludhiana in Punjab. In fact, through active community engagement, it has developed one of the most successful water conservation initiatives in this region. Take a look.
United Breweries has also undertaken a water conservation project through participative community mobilization in partnership with the Energy and Resources Institute, or TERI. The overall objective of the project is to facilitate water conservation through community participation in villages of Ludhiana, Patiala and Alwar districts through the transformation of ponds. The idea is that sustainable water conservation interventions can be achieved only through the active participation of all stakeholders.
These ponds that I'm talking about were nothing but completely defunct and were used as garbage dumps and wastewater collection pits. And now if you see, these ponds have become a pride for the village. These are not just used as the basic purpose of it is obviously conserving the rainwater and harvesting it. But besides that, it's also becoming a social gathering place. People meet socially in this place because it's beautiful.
Before the implementation of the water conservation project at Katani Kalan village in Ludhiana, most of the farmers were facing a water crisis in the village. Sufficient water for irrigation and farming was not available.
देखिए पहले से ही खेती करते हैं पहले यहाँ जो जैसे आपको पता है पानी का लेवल बहुत अप था उसके बाद जब से ये धान का चला है काम वाटर लेवल डाउन हो रहा था डे बाय डे तो अभी पानी की बहुत दिक्कत थी जो हमारे बोरवेल हैं उनको नीचे करना पड़ता था समर्सिबल लगाने पड़ते थे मतलब जो पहले 20-25 फीट पानी था अभी वो 80-90 फीट तक चला गया
After the renewal of a pond, through United Breweries Water Conservation Project, the groundwater level has increased and has benefited farmers and the villagers in the area.
ये जब से ये पॉन्ड बना है तब से हमारे ये दिक्कत दूर हो गई है जो मोटर पानी नहीं उठाती थी मोटर चला देते थे पानी नहीं आता था इससे पानी का लेवल अप्रोक्सीमेटली 8 से 10 फीट ज़्यादा अप हो गया है इस रेनिंग सीजन में एक दो महीने में जो ये बारिश हुई है जो भी अच्छी बारिश हुई है उससे पानी का लेवल 8-10 फीट अप हो गया है तो अभी हमें पानी की दिक्कत नहीं है
A common water conservation implementation framework for pond rejuvenation has been designed for the selected villages. Under this project, the selected pond sites were dewatered, cleaned and landscaped and taken up for wastewater management. Injection wells were built in the ponds for groundwater recharge. The wastewater is now managed in such a manner that it does not find its way straight into the pond and the groundwater level is recharged by clean water entering the pond. A scientific assessment was done to evaluate the recharge potential of each of the 8 ponds using GIS techniques and available data on rainfall and soil type.
Terry has joined hands with United Breweries Ltd, UBL, on its initiative to look into projects on water conservation. The idea is to rejuvenate these ponds, but very importantly, with a very methodical approach. It's not just an intervention where you go and dig a particular pond. It's basically about engaging a scientific process of identifying scientifically what is the correct way of rejuvenating, but very importantly as well, engaging the local community for the sustainability of the interventions.
The Village Development Committees, or VDCs, formed under this project for each of the sites consist of small, active community members with representation from the women folk as well. This group is responsible for providing inputs and suggestions in the planning and implementation phase. The projects are then handed over to the village community on completion, and this committee is responsible for maintenance of these ponds. As a part of engaging community in this project, awareness creation and sensitization meetings were held at various levels.
There was huge issue concerning water logging in our locality. Water used to get filled up till almost 4 feet of height. We used to then commute using tractors. Thereafter, UBL and Terry groups intervened and developed this area into a beautiful park. It's all due to their efforts that we are breathing in a cleaner, safer environment, free from pollution.
ये लेक सर बहुत ही अच्छा बन चुका अभी लेकिन पहले अगर आप यहाँ का दृश्य देखते तो मेरे हिसाब से यहाँ पर रुकना भी एक मिनट के लिए भी बदतर था बहुत स्मेल था और अभी हम सबसे पहले थैंक्स करेंगे यूबीएल कंपनी टेरी कंपनी का उन्होंने हमें संजोग दिया और यहाँ पर आकर बहुत बढ़िया काम कर दिया लेक बना दिया पार्क बना दिया बच्चों के लिए घूमने हो गया सुबह शाम सैर करने के लिए हो गया और अभी हम हर प्रकार से कह सकते हैं कि यहाँ पर रहने योग है
United Breweries is leaving no stone unturned to fulfill its commitment of being a water neutral company by 2025, a stance that is visible from its various water conservation projects implemented across India.
We have a goal that by 2025, United Breweries Limited would like to be water balance positive, which means that we would like to put back to productive use or recharge, to use a simpler word, as much fresh water as we consume. Now that's not an easy objective because what it means is that we have to work with communities, we have to work with the water bodies, and we have to work in conjunction, not just with the communities we operate in, but also regulatory authorities to make sure that the projects are both environmentally responsible as well as benefit all the stakeholders there.
UBL intends to be a water neutral company and all our efforts are directed towards that. We want to make sure that all the areas that we have not already covered under our water conservation interventions are covered around each of our breweries are now undertaken as part of our future water neutrality and positivity journey. We want to communicate to the community living in these rural areas is the criticality of water conservation because their lives and livelihoods are most closely dependent on issues of water and the scarcity of water can have a very deep impact on their lives. From the government, we kind of expect support in terms of getting smoother permission processes so that we can implement our projects in a more efficient manner. With all this being in place, I think we'll sprint towards our water neutrality goal at a much faster pace.
The United Breweries strategy of working with NGO partners, the panchayat and community members and village development committees is making a significant difference in people's lives. United Breweries is one of the change makers that is leading by example.
Well, that's all we have for today. Next time, we'll feature yet another corporation that is committed to the cause of sustainable development goals of the United Nations and is catalyzing development in the country through its CSR activities. Do tune in next time as we bring you another exciting CSR story on the Changemakers exclusively on CNBC TV 18. Thanks for joining us today. Goodbye.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.